I can remember it like it was yesterday.
17 years later, Lisa Albert-Vaughn vividly remembers the days leading up to September 25th. Her 20-year-old son was mowing her father's yard off Grogan Road in Stoneville when he found a child's tennis shoe.
He didn't really think anything about it because he always found items that the dogs had drug up. And a few days later, he had threw away what he assumed to be a wig.
Just days before, Lisa was washing her car when she made a discovery of her own, a set of teeth near the end of the driveway.
My dad was like, oh, it's probably just animals, because there's deer and rabbits and squirrels and all kind of animals here. And Dad was like, don't worry about it.
A rural area beside a pond and creek. It wasn't until one of the family dogs was playing with what appeared to be a turtle shell that Lisa's father realized something wasn't right. He called over a friend in law enforcement to take a look.
He said, I'm afraid that's not a turtle shell, it's a skull. And then we realized we wasn't sure about that wig.
The remains found scattered across the property were later identified as 9-year-old Jennifer Short.
It just really rips you apart. It's like, how could she end up here, right here on our property? And from then on, she became part of our family.
She remembers watching investigators drain the pond on her father's land and search for evidence near the property.
Then as they walked over the property, over behind us, they would put down flags. And there was flags. You couldn't count how many flags was out there. And every flag stood for a piece of her body or a piece of evidence that was laying out there.
Over in this area right here that's kind of grown up a little bit, the creek area was being searched. We had cadaver dogs and all kinds of support out here. We had officers and deputies and police officers all over Henry County, Rockingham County, investigators just basically coming through the area to see if there's any evidentiary remains that they could go off of.
Lisa's father remained involved with the case for years, watching for suspicious drivers and inviting deputies onto his property, even into his home as needed.
Come and use my driveway. Do whatever you have to. Use my yard, use my house. Find out what happened to this little girl. Because she did. She became part of us. She became part of our family.
Like so many others, he wanted the closure that never came.
He had hoped before he passed away that they would find out who done this. We always discussed it. We always went over scenarios, and especially the one, how did this little girl get from Virginia to here? Why did she end up here in this area? And it was always on his heart.
With children of her own and a granddaughter the same age Jennifer was when she disappeared, Lisa says she only wishes her family could have found the 9-year-old sooner.
Because we all wanted to know what happened to this little girl and who could do such a horrific thing to her.